bring predictive analytics into all aspects of the consumer journey with us. Right, so just as a kind of simple examples, at the planning stage, when we are serving up marketing messages, we, as I said earlier, try and identify whether this is a deal seeker or an experience seeker. Before they arrive, we have pre-arrival personalization so that we know what are the products to upsell, what are the ancillary revenues to personalize for the individual. And of course, when they arrive finally at the front desk, we also provide some analytics to advise the front desk agent as to what should be the best room type to speak to this particular person about. I know we've been training a lot of our employees before this about observing, you know, is the person coming for business, is the person coming as a couple and all that. So some of these things is great. You can, as there's nothing like a person being able to identify and tell that, but we can also actually program it up front so that it's consistent across the group. And then on stay, we utilize something called a loyalty score, so we actually provide a bit of a predictive value for each of our customers who are repeat, so that we can understand what type of operational and service elements to be able to provide and even make the stay experience even better. Just as another example is post-stay, we collect a lot of information about their satisfaction, so either on social review sites or in your own guest satisfaction survey, and that is just such a valuable database. So being able to kind of model things like the guest sentiments and the text analytics is really quite critical, and it's a rich, rich database that we have.